Wow. Much greeting this morning. I believe that you had a wonderful night. And I want to thank God that you have a great day today to enjoy the direction of God in your life. And because of this opportunity, Rebecca, to share with you the Word of God, who is going to help us as Christians. And today, friend, I want to talk to you about God reward through commitment. That's the topic. So let us go to the Word of God, which we are going to read in Matthew chapter number 24 and verse number 45. The Bible says, Who then is a faithful and a wise servant, whom his Lord hath made a ruler of his household, to give them meat in due season? So God is a rewarder, because to this faithful servant, he is going to give meat to the due season. That's a reward from God. 46 says, Blessed is that servant who is Lord when he cometh shall find so doing. God is looking for somebody who is doing the work of the Lord. And that person will be rewarded. And 47 says, Verily I say unto you, that he shall make him a ruler of all his goods. The Lord God will make a ruler of all his goods. So here, God is talking about rewarding. So, God rewards through commitment. So, when we are committed to the work of God, when we are committed to the will of God, when we are committed to what God is telling us, we'll be rewarded. So, thank God that our commitment to the ministry, to the work of God, will reward us according to the word that you've learned. God is raising men and women who are committed to his work. So if you are going to be committed to his work, we must know that there's a reward. Then God wants to reward people who are ready to do extraordinary things. When you go to the next mile, when you go to extraordinary things, will be a reward. Friends, let us continue to be committed to what God has commanded us to do. When you talk about commitment, what is commitment? Commitment is, it is an act of giving yourself to something or someone, or to abide by as by a promise. So as we continue to do that, we are very sure that we will be rewarded of the Lord. And please, let us know that as we continue to be committed to God, as we know that there's a reward, we must also know that there are things that we need to know about commitment. There are many, but let me give you five things. One of them, greet people who have been used by God, are committed to the things of God. So anybody that you know, anybody that you have heard, anybody that you have learned, it's somebody who has already committed himself or herself to the things of God. It's very important for you to know that. Number two, commitment is what separate it separate commitment separate doers from dreamers and good from great. Friends, we must realize that. When you know that, we are going to be committed so much that we can they can be as separate as separation. In Jesus' name. Number three, commitments give new power. No matter what, you will keep your eyes on God. Number four, committed people leave remarkable marks in life of the people. The people that have lived the remarkable marks are the people who are committed. So my dear friends, anybody that you know, anybody who has a remarkable marks, remarkable things here on earth, is somebody who was actually, you know, committed. And number five, commitment is the key to success. Listen, commitment is the key to success. No success, no reward. So when we are talking about God rewarding, then there must be commitment that we can be able to succeed, and when we succeed, then we are going to be rewarded. But as we continue doing that work, we also must know that there are enemies of our commitment. And number one enemy is called excuses. Adam gave an excuses why he sinned by blaming God for the wife he has given him. You know, Adam started giving him excuses by blaming God for the wife that he gave him. He started giving him an excuses. So an excuses is an enemy. So let us be careful. Let us be sharp of any excuses. Number two enemy is called pride. Pride is also an enemy. Pride is to be an arrogant. And we must be very careful with that enemy, that we don't be arrogant people. Pride also creates gaps. So when you become proud, I must know that I'm making, or rather I'm creating gaps from people. So pride is very dangerous. It is an enemy to our commitment. Pride also makes somebody feel more important than anybody else. Pride makes somebody feel more important than anybody else. Have you ever come across somebody who feels that he is very important than anybody else? Have you ever had somebody who is very arrogant? Pride creates gaps. May the Lord help you and help you that you don't become arrogant people. We don't feel so important than other people. And we don't also create gaps in our relationship with other people. Pride also hinders us from seeing God's action. So when we become arrogant, when we become proud, Bible says that the pride hinders us from seeing God in action. And we are supposed to manifest the manifestation of God. But God's manifestation cannot be manifested. It is hindered. God's manifestation is hindered by pride. Let us manifest the glory of God. Because when we are proud, God's manifestation cannot be manifested. It hinders God's action. It cannot be seen. Pride also ruins relationship. is so bad that pride can ruin relationship. Your relationship with your friend, your relationship with your colleague, your relationship with your family. May the Lord deliver you. May the Lord help you. May the Lord also help me that I don't ruin relationship with the people, because relationship is very important in this life that we are. Because we are looking to be rewarded of the Lord, and we must be committed to what God is telling us, that we can be able to enjoy the reward. As the Bible says, a wise servant, you'll be rewarded by the Lord. Another exercise is called laziness. Laziness is also an enemy. We must be very careful. Let us be hardworking people in the kingdom, even the work that God has given us. We need to be hardworking people. Let us not be lazy people. Because lazy people don't go. Lazy people don't go for commitment. Lazy people don't go for commitment. May the Lord deliver you from laziness. May the Lord deliver me from any laziness. Because lazy people don't commit themselves. If you're not committed to the things of God, you must know that laziness, lazy people don't commit themselves. Number four, enemy is called sin. Sin destroys godliness in our life. Sin destroys godliness in our life. Sin also ends people in great shame. Sin can bring shame in your life. Sin can bring shame in my life. So we are supposed to fight this enemy of our commitment. Number five, enemy of our commitment is lack of clear vision. Lack of clear vision. People with no clear vision and purpose are busy doing nothing. That is not your portion. It is not my portion. May our vision be very clear, and let us continue to be busy doing things of God. And the last one for today, my dear friends, is wrong company. Wrong company is also an enemy of our commitment. I don't know whom you are working with. I don't know whom you share your heart with. I don't know whom you pour your heart to. But let me tell you, wrong people are also an enemy of our commitment. Wrong people around us affect how we think and act. So, wrong people around you affect how you think and act. And for those few points that I have given you, as you continue to be committed to His work, you are going to enjoy the blessing that God has for you, that God has for me, as you continue to be committed to the things of God, because there's a reward. And let us be very careful to know the enemy of our commitment as we continue to serve this good God in our life. May the Lord lift you. May the Lord reward you. May the Lord give you a next level of what you are doing. May you receive the blessing of God as you go out and as you come in. May the peace of God be with you as you continue to serve the Lord in any area of your life. In Jesus' name.